Up next is Nick Chuckas.
Just this year, 3,165 people in the United States alone have been killed as a result of gun violence. Hi, my name is Nicholas Chuckas, and I'm a junior at AITE, and I'd like to start off by asking all of you to take a moment and put yourselves in the shoes of a victim of gun violence. Step into the life of one of those 3,165 people. You live a normal life. Maybe you have a family, a couple kids, a good job. Or maybe you're a student with your entire life ahead of you. And in a moment, and in an instant, all that's gone. Your family left to cope. Your kids left fatherless or motherless. Your life stripped from you. Everyone and everything you were, gone. You were killed, shot, for no reason at all. How would you feel? What would you do if you knew this was going to happen to you? A lot of times we disregard the fact that this could happen to us. These victims didn't choose to be shot. They didn't want to be killed. They just left their home one day and they never returned. Why is this acceptable? Why is this being allowed to continue? It doesn't make sense. 96 people a day. 3,165 people in less than 3 months. Yet, people still back the availability of weapons like AR-15s and M50s. This is blasphemy. No one in their right mind needs to carry an assault weapon with the capability to tear through human flesh like tissue paper. I understand that banning guns entirely would be nearly impossible, but realistic change can happen. After all, why is an AR-15 or an M50 needed to engage in recreational activities or self-defense? It's not. There's a distinction between simple handguns and these weapons. Bullets from assault weapons are shot at triple the velocity, creating 9 times the energy and 9 times the power, making the weapon 9 times as deadly. These weapons are used to kill. We have the ability to end the violence. Even the smallest change can bring that number of 3,165 closer and closer to zero, right where it should be. We can be the change we want to see in the world. Now, before I go, I just want to leave you all with one thing to think about. What would you do if you knew that you were going to be the next victim? Would you do nothing? Thank you. And I